Today we are going to discuss why you need the consumption meter for your solar system. Alright, welcome back to the channel. This is Paul, and today we're going to take a look at my solar system and why I decided to get the consumption meter installed. In my opinion, the consumption meter is a very crucial meter that you need in order to determine how much you are drawing from the grid and what you are putting back out to the grid. That is assuming if you want real-time data. Of course, you can get this information from the meter that your utility company installs. However, it is not real-time update on your app, and it does not sync in with the solar panel app that you have on your phone. In my case, I actually went with Enphase for my solar system install, and the Enphase app has the option to toggle on consumption. However, in my install, I was not given the option to get the consumption meter installed. And so I had to, after the fact, get the sensor installed myself. Now, the cost to get this consumption meter installed was quoted $200 if I had it installed during the installation of my solar. However, I was not given that option, or I was not made aware of that option, so I didn't get it installed when they were installing my panels. After I figured out that I needed this consumption meter in order to understand my system as a whole and what I'm producing and feeding back to the grid versus what I'm consuming throughout the day, I had to get the consumption meter installed. And so I did order two from Amazon, and I'll leave the link in the description below of the exact consumption meter that I purchased. Now, in a standard install, you will need two, one for each 120 volts of power. For most setups, you do have 240 volts coming into your house with the neutral or the ground wire, and so you have a total of three cables. So the consumption meters would have to be wired around the two hot leads from the utility company that's coming into your panel. And they have to be connected in a certain fashion with the arrow pointing up or to your load. I did get a quote, and I checked around to get the consumption meter installed. The quote that I received was about $500. And after looking at my setup and determining how I could route the wires, it was actually cheaper if I just did it myself. And based on what I saw, it actually wasn't too hard to install. I did look at the panels, open them up, and try to figure out how I could route the wires from the consumption meter. I first opened up the consumption meter to see, you know, the length of the wires that were available to me from the consumption meter. And then based on that, I figured out if I needed to extend or if I could use the leads that were already there. And in my case, it was long enough, so I didn't have to extend anything. So I went ahead and proceeded, went to Lowe's to buy all the necessary conduits and elbows and fittings. And then I fitted the conduit, cut and made sure that everything fit the way it's supposed to fit. And then I installed it onto my unit and then ran the wires and then connected the wires to my Enphase combiner box. Two critical things here. Well, the first off is safety, of course, because you're dealing with high voltage. In my case, I just made sure that the power was off, and then I made sure that I wasn't fiddling with the power that was coming from the utility. So make sure to turn off your breakers before you do anything with your electrical power. After you run your wires through the conduit and you're ready to connect the consumption meter to your combiner, make sure that you follow the instruction. You have to make sure to connect your consumption meter on the right cable that's coming from the utility power. And it should be the lead that goes all the way back, connects to the breaker, feeds back all the way to the solar panel. And it's got to be the one where the primary consumption meter is also clamped onto. So in my case, it was the black lead, and I was able to measure that and trace it all the way back to my panel just to make sure that when I connect my consumption meter, I have it on the same one where I'm metering the production meter. In my case with Enphase, after connecting this consumption meter and getting it installed, I had to open up a support ticket with Enphase to have them turn it on. And what they'll do is they're not going to turn on right away, but they will test the system out first and make sure that the consumption meter is actually working properly before they turn it on across the board. All right, so here is a closer look at my dashboard I'm actually on the web version because that's easier for me to see when I'm at home. But with installing the consumption meter, it actually unlocks a few features here. First of which is this right here. You have this consume toggle here that you can actually turn on or off if you want to see what your house is pulling from the grid. And then here we have the imported and exported. All right, quick break here. I just want to give a shout out to Project Solar for installing my system. They did a great job and they actually gave me one of the best quotes. So if you need a third quote, give Project Solar a try. I have them down in the description below. Just click on that link to get yourself a quote. And now back to the video. I can toggle this back and forth and it'll show me what I am pulling from the grid and what I'm sending back to the grid. And it's this gray bar here. The orange bar again is consumed. And when the sun comes out, we get this blue bar, which is what I'm producing. So currently in my peak, I am producing about 6.8 kilowatts of power. So this is my dashboard and it actually shows me really quick what I'm consuming on this graph here, what I've exported, what I've imported, what I've produced. And so with this meter installed, you have the option of seeing or understanding the full picture of what your solar power is producing, what you're pulling from the grid, and what you're pushing back to the grid. All right, so thank you for stopping by and listening to the end. And I hope that you will find some value in this video. And I hope that if you do have a solar system and you don't have the consumption meter installed, you probably might want to ask about it and seek to see if you can have one installed so that you can actually be monitoring what you are using and what you are feeding back into the grid. Anyhow, if you would like to purchase the consumption meter, I do have it in my description below. If you have any questions, feel free to drop down a comment. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. That would really help me out. And until next time, guys, I'll see you in the next video.